we bring about real change, positive change.
My line is, the world is changed by those who show up. Social media is great, it works great, whatever. But you have to keep involved in your community any way you can. And you've got to get off your ass and you have to show up to rallies like this, to city council meetings. I'm the environmentalist right, trying to block the waste. I show up to the consent hearings we have. There's two people there. You know, and they're well advertised. People don't come. My generation, they lost their way a long time ago. But it's your generation. Don't do what we did. Don't just, you know, get selfish and meme it and, you know, show up and get involved in the community. And just keep doing this. Like she says, don't stop. Don't stop. You got something going. Keep going.
There's an agency called Indivisible Utah. Her name is Brenda. Contact her. She'll put it on her link. It's an organization just for some of the same thing.
All right. So kind of adding to what you were saying before about Congress is that so
did
in
you
November,
want to come up?
Yeah.
Southern Poverty Law actually puts out a judge, like, educational guy for each state, so you can educate yourself about the judges and, like, how they're actually prosecuting people. So that's, like, one of the biggest things you can do is just show people for your local representatives in the election this November, but also judges is the biggest thing. Nobody votes about them. They just get it. It's like a life-threatening incumbency. So if you want to hold the people about, accountable, show them November.
Amen. Yeah.
I don't care what your political stance is. I don't care where you fall on the spectrum. It is important that you are choosing people who represent your best interests. And when it's your best interest, it's your neighbor's best interest, and that's what it means. Is it's building up our communities. The betterment of my community, equality for my community, the Black community, is ultimately the betterment for everyone's. Because as a society, as a culture, as a country, we all have to be at our best. We all have to be equal. We've never said that all lives don't matter. But like some of your signs say, all lives can't matter until Black lives matter, brown lives matter. This has to be, we all have to be equal. We all have to be on the same playing field. We all have to have equal grounds here.
Yeah.
And so that's why it's important to get involved. Even if you don't care about politics, I know that politics are exhausting. They're nauseating. But
yeah.
Getting involved down here starts change all the way up there. Change here, if we take this as far as we can go to the White House. We can go past the White House. That's how significant we are. That's how it's important for us to speak up and speak out and be loud. Because they're always going to try to be louder than us. They can't be louder than me. I've been yelling all afternoon. They can't be louder than us. Yeah, come up. Because it's kind of important.
Alright, so I don't know a lot of you, and I'm actually pretty young. I'm 15.
Wow, 15.
But I came here with my friends to not only support everybody here, but to support people of color. Because I'm white, obviously, if you can tell. But even white people are sick of this. Like,
yeah.
Even white people are sick of racism. This is, like, outrageous. And each and every one of you who are white,
yeah.
Like, without us, without everybody here coming together, here, this is amazing. All of you guys are amazing. This is change right here, exactly
yeah.
What she said. I'm here for her, and I don't even know her. I love her. I love all you guys, and I don't even know how.
Love you.
Love you. This is amazing. This is change right here. This is everything everybody needs to be involved in. And I'm so proud of everybody's here. I'm proud of myself for coming here.
Right on. I like that. You gonna get up and talk?
I love you, Daphne. But seriously,
you couldn't.
And if you're white and if you're privileged just like I am, use your voice.
Mm-hmm.
Seriously. That's all I gotta say.
Nice. Good job.
Good work too. As each one of you keeps speaking and we keep cheering. and then we were loud, and then it was really loud, and then it echoed across the whole thing.
And then we lost our voices.
And then we lost our voices. But I heard your power, and I heard your significance. The other day, I had people who worked down the road saying, hey, I could hear you guys on the corner. That's physically how loud we are. Imagine figuratively how significant you are and how loud you are. They're hearing us on a street corner. But I hear you, I see you. And I'm so grateful from the bottom of my heart for every single person who showed up and showed out, and they showed out loud. You guys are loud. And that's the one thing I want you to take away from this, is that you are loud and you are significant and you are powerful.
Woo!
Amen. Woo! What's that, Pant?
Undermine that. Invalidate that. Take that away from you. It doesn't matter if you're black, white, or brown. It doesn't matter if you're somewhere in between that. You are loud. You are significant. And imagine what we sound like all together. If one of us can create change, imagine all of us. All of us here. And then imagine your friends who support you. And then the people don't even know you. I don't know half of you. But you're here.
So power to the youth. Power to the youth.
We mean power to the people. We mean power to the youth.
Yes.
So speak up. I said speak up.
Power to the youth.
All right, you want to share? Yeah, so, like Sierra said, I didn't catch your name, but like, yeah. Vote. Vote when you can. If you can, vote. Vote for representatives that will make a change. November's coming up. Ironically, the day that everybody was tear gassed at Lafayette Park was election day in D.C. So,
peace figure got tear gassed this week.
Know your dates. Know when to show up and who to show up for. Know.
Right.
Because, you know, no one's going to have your back unless you have your back. And we all right here, we have each other's back. And I know that we do. You know, asking each other, you know, do you need water? Snacks, you want pizza? We had each other's backs, and half of us didn't even know each other, right? We all just made a bond with someone today, and that was really, really special. So, like we said, you know, do what you can, watch those videos, vote for people, listen to people, you know, get your information. At the same time, you know, do what you can to change people's minds. Me and Sierra argue with my super, like, white conservative grandfather in the Facebook comment section constantly. It's exhausting, but we do it. We tag team it. It's amazing.
It's beautiful.
It's absolutely wonderful.
Nice.
Stand up for what you believe in, whether it's against family, whether it's against people you thought you were friends with for years and years and years. I grew up with a girl, and just the other day I saw her comment that she would hit protesters with her car. That's not okay. And you need to speak up.
Report them.
Like that.
Report those people.
Report them.
Yeah, to the police. Yeah, they're going to do something.
All right.
On Facebook.
Yeah, there you go.
As a thought.
Yeah.
Don't call the police, call grandma.
Right.
When you see injustices online, don't ignore it. Don't dislike it. Screenshot it. Share it. Don't let them get away with this anymore, because that's how racism reads, is it's left in the silence, and it's left in the dark, and it gets ignored. Some of you, who will remain anonymous, have a history of taking screenshots of people saying racist, inappropriate things, and they get called out for it. It's about accountability. It's about responsibility. If we want change, we need to hold these people accountable. The police need to be held accountable.
Yeah.
Our lawmakers need to be held accountable. Our president, our Congress, they need to be held accountable.
They need locked up.
We shouldn't have to do this. It makes me sick to my stomach that we have to do this.
Yeah.
It makes me physically ill that I have to beg people, don't be racist. It's wrong. That shouldn't be a thing.
Yeah.
But we have to, and we're here, and we're doing it now.
But you gotta be brave enough to take the backlash. I moved into this apartment complex. The ordinary setting president was racist, and I told her so. And I said, that is a racist comment. I love everybody. She's trying to hug me. I said, you stay away from me, you racist. And her Mormon people went against me to try to get me evicted, because I stood up and said, that is racist.
now. This is a community. That's my brother. That's my brother. That's my sister. You are all my family. That's my brother. That's my sister. You are my family. Because you showed up and you showed out for me and my community when I needed you, when we needed you. So when you do that, I will do that for you.
Yeah.
Stand up for other minorities. Stand up for other marginalized groups. Stand up for your friend. Stand up for your family. Stand up for a stranger. Stand up for people. Have people's backs. That's for our community. We are a community. We are a family. This is Ogden.
Yeah.
This is Ogden. This is Plain City. This is Hooper. This is all of them. This is Layton. We are family. And so when you stand up for injustice and when you stand up for what's wrong, you have an army behind you. It's scary. Be afraid. If anyone has a problem with you calling out racism, injustice, inequality, you have all of us backing you. Every single one of us will show up and show out for you, and we'll be loud about it too.
Yeah.
Every single one of us. If any of you need something, I will be there. She will be there. You will be there. You will be there. I know it. I can feel it. I can feel the empowerment that we feed off of each other. I can feel it. So if we stand up for what's wrong in this country, what's wrong in this world, what's wrong in this community, they will have no choice but to listen. They have to listen to us. What are they going to do? Are they going to stand up against all of us?
Hell no.
That's ballsy if they do.
For real.
That's ballsy. But they won't. So that's why every single one of us, we need to keep showing up and showing out and bring your friends. Build our family. Let our family grow. We are the majority. We are not the minority. We overpower racism. We overpower hatred and bigotry and evil because it's wrong. We are bigger. We are badder. We are meaner.
Amen.
I didn't know you guys were about to get me in trouble for